So we have till now studied the weathering part in geomorphology. Now coming to the end part of geomorphology, there are two small concepts, one related to the erosion. Now the first thing, as we say this, we will be starting with the topic known as erosion of the landforms. Erosion means leveling down of the landforms, same what happens in weathering. But as what is the English word erosion? Erosion means removing something, eroding something. So the erosion and geography is different from weathering, that both includes, how they are similar, that both includes removing of the or leveling down or bringing down the surface of the earth, but they are different. In weathering is a static process, that is there is no large scale transportation involved except under the influence of gravity, which we have done in the landslide, etc. But now there is a second part, that is the erosion part. Erosion is again a leveling down of the land surface, but under the influence of some kind of a transporting agent. The transporting agent means the anything, any geomorphical feature on the surface of the earth which moves. So river moves, glacier moves, wind moves. So the erosion by running water in the form of a river, erosion by running water in the limestone regions, erosion by running water in the desert regions, erosion by water in the coastal regions, that is near the seashore, are one type of erosion and the landforms they make. This is one topic. So we will be doing here in this the different kind of landforms. The erosion by the glacier, that is the moving ice. But before that, before we go, there is a very very small concept of drainage system and drainage pattern. So what the questions can be, what explain the different types of a drainage system, or distinguish between the drainage system and the drainage pattern. In the preliminary examination, the common question is, what is a trilized drainage pattern, what is a rectangular drainage pattern, what do you mean by antecedent drainage pattern, what do you mean by superimposed drainage pattern and their drainage system and their examples. So there are two concepts here, drainage system and drainage pattern. The two different words, system and pattern. What is the meaning of the word pattern? What do you mean by the word pattern? See, the pattern, does it mean this any kind of a design, any kind of a geographical, any kind of a design? What is the pattern of the design on your shirt? What is the pattern of a design on the some kind of an object? So pattern means a geographical shape, sorry, it means a shape. So in the drainage pattern, we will come to the geographical shape because we are doing geography. Now system, system means the entire process. How did it involve? How is it working? So for example, Indian political system, Indian governmental system, we say that, generally we say, main to achha hu, system kharab hai. Ya is system mein kaam kaise kar sakte. That means something which has evolved for a long period of time, that is a system. So same thing you apply to the geography part. What is a drainage system? Drainage system means how did the rivers evolve? How did the rivers get that kind of a flow, or what is the direction of a flow, and why such particular kind of a system evolved in the drainage? For example, you will see some of the rivers which are flowing as per the slope of a land. If the land is dipping this way, the river is also flowing downwards. But some rivers are there which cut down the mountains and they flow after cutting the mountains. For example, if you want to see beautiful valleys, high mountains, which part of the world in India will go? You will go to the mountain region. If you want to see the flat, very very wide river, you will go to the plain region. So that means these are the two different type of characteristics. So mountainous region, the rivers are cutting the mountains and flowing. In the flat region, the rivers are generally flowing according to the slope of a land. So these are the two different concepts. The first coming up with the system. System means how did the river system evolve, or what is the reason for the evolution of a river system. So you will take the first definition of a system, that is it refers to the origin. And development. It refers to the origin and development of what topic we are doing? Obviously of a river system, of a streams. While the drainage pattern refers to, the drainage pattern refers to the shapes, geometrical shapes which have been developed over an area. Shape of rivers, that what is the shape of a rivers. For example, some of the rivers have such kind of a shape, which will come to it later on. That is, they have tree like pattern. Some of the rivers are having barbed wire like pattern. Some of the rivers are having different, too much meandering, resulting into different types of a pattern. So the system is refers to the origin and development of a rivers, while the pattern refers to the shape of a particular river system. Now the first topic which we are going to study is the drainage system. Now when the river is flowing through an area, what will be the determining factors of the drainage system? For example, if a river is flowing through this landmass which is present here, the major determining factor will be what is the slope of a land in this region, and the other determining factor will be what will be the type of the rocks or what is the geological structure in this region. So the slope, that is whether it is dipping in one part or other, and the second is geological structure, that is whether the land is folded, the folded land, whether the land is faulted land. For example, folded land structure, the Himalayan system has a different kind of a drainage pattern as compared to the faulted land system, that is the Vindhyan system and the Satpura system. So Narmada has a different kind of a river. Narmada, which flows through a rift valley, as we have already done, it flows through a rift valley. It has a different kind of a origin as compared to the river Ganga, which flows through the Himalayan region. So the drainage system refers, which refers to the origin and development of a river, it is based on the nature of an initial slope, it is based on nature of initial slope, and second, it is based on geological structure. That is, what will be the, what is the geological structure, whether the area is folded or faulted or joint rock system is there, etc. This is the geological structure. An example is river which originates, it will follow the slope of a land and it will go in certain direction. Maybe if the river is not, if the river is there is in a mountainous region, it may cut this valley, cut this mountain to maintain its original course and flow through a deep valley. And it may flow through this deep valley after cutting this mountain system. So in the areas of folding, faulting, etc., what will be the kind of an system? So the drainage system, which is origin and development of a rivers, depends on nature of initial surface and the geological structure. Now there are two different types of a drainage system. One system of a drainage follows the original slope of a land, and the other system is which do not follow the original system of land. Now to explain you in very very simple terms with the example, look at this figure. Himalayan mountain system, the three mountain systems of the Himalayas. The Western Ghat region, that is the again one of the steepest mountain system in India. Now most of the rivers, where does the river Godavari originate? Godavari originates somewhere in the Trimbakeshwar, in the Trimbakeshwar region, in the Western Ghat region. River Krishna also originates here nearby in the Western Ghat region. Now every river should go and meet the sea. Obviously this every river meets the sea, that is it empties into the sea. But river Godavari, rather than going to the Arabian Sea, it goes and meets the Bay of Bengal. Same with river Krishna, same with river Kaveri. So these are the rivers which flow right from one part of western India to the eastern India and empty into the Bay of Bengal region. That why do they flow? Why do not they directly cut through the mountains and go and meet the Arabian Sea here? Why? This is because the nature of a slope. The Indian slope, India is slanting right slightly this way. If you look at the great watershed area of India, there is a watershed. This is the area of India in which this part is tilting this way, while the other part is tilting the other way. So as a result of this, there is a tilt in the land of India. If the India is not a flat as in, it is tilting. The eastern part is tilting this way, while the western part is tilting the on the western side. And as a result, the rivers which originate here flow the direction or flow this way and into the Bay of Bengal region. The rivers, there are numerous small rivers which originate on the western side of a western ghat, and they flow because the tilt of a land is the on the other side, they go and meet the Arabian Sea. So you see, these are the rivers which flow follow the slope of a land. These are the rivers which follow the general dip or direction of the land surface. On other hand, look at the rivers which originate in the Himalayas. River Ganga, River Indus, River Satluj, River Brahmaputra. Now these are, Ganga does not flow this way, go up according to the slope of the land and then goes and meets somewhere in the Indian Ocean. It cuts through the mountains. It here cuts through the mountains only in the Himalayan region, and then it comes to the plains at Haridwar, and then obviously it is following the slope of a land and meeting the Bay of Bengal. Same like with Brahmaputra. Brahmaputra is following, then suddenly it is cutting through this three mountains and meeting Ganga. After joining Ganga, it flows as a one river. River Indus, it flows in this direction, it cuts through these three mountains. It is not hampered, it does not change the direction because of the presence of the mountains. It actually erodes the mountains, it cuts through the mountains, and then it goes and meets the Arabian Sea and the Indian Ocean. Satluj enters India through Shipkila Pass, meets River Indus, that is after cutting the mountain system. So you see, the Himalayan rivers, they are not object, their path is not broken, or their path is not changed because of the presence of the mighty Himalayas. They cut through the Himalayas. Can the rivers really cut through the Himalayas? Try scratching this wall. If you keep it for persistent period of time, and if your nail permits, you will be able to dig a hole in the wall. That is the power of persistence. That is the power of erosion. So be persistent. Even the rivers were persistent. Be persistent with your studies also, that you can even cut through the mighty Himalayas. Similar to them, for you, UPSC is similar to the Himalayan region, Himalayas. So here, these are the rivers which cut through the Himalayas. They are do not change their path because of the presence of the Himalayas. These are the rivers which flow with the slope of the land. So based on this, the drainage system, we classify the rivers into two types. One which follow the slope of the land, the other which do not follow the slope of the land. So the drainage system is classified into, sequent drainage system, and insequent drainage system. So we classify the drainage system into the sequent drainage system and the insequent drainage system. Sequent drainage system, as I told you, follow the regional slope. They follow the regional slope and are well adjusted to the geological structure. They follow the regional slope. They are adjusted to the geological structure of a land. That is, whether there is a folding in the areas of folding, if there is an anticline this way, the rivers will come down through the fold and come downwards and through the anticline. These are well adjusted to their geological structure. They are adjusted to the land surface. And geological structure. On other hand, the in-sequence system, opposite of a sequence system, these are not well adjusted to the geological structure. They do not follow the regional slope. They do not follow the slope of a land. And are not well adjusted or geological structure. So look here again. The in-sequent versus the sequent drainage system, they follow the regional slope of the land and are adjusted to the geological structure, which is this sequent. While the in-sequent, they do not follow the regional slope and therefore are not adjusted to the land or geological structure. These are the two types of a drainage system. Now, the drainage system are further classified, that we will again further classify the sequent system into different types and the in-sequent system into different types. So, based on this, the sequent system is further classified into consequent system. Subsequent system obsequent system and resequent system. And resequent drainage system. So they are further classified into consequent, subsequent, obsequent and resequent drainage system. While the insequent drainage system are classified into two types, antecedent river system and superimposed drainage system. And superimposed drainage system. DS, that is the drainage system. Don't do this in the examination. I'm just using here to save the time. So the consequent drainage system, subsequent, obsequent and resequent are the part of sequent drainage system which follow the regional slope of a land, while the insequent drainage system are the part of antecedent drainage system or the superimposed drainage system which do not follow the regional slope of the land. Now let us study each and every drainage system in separately. That is, what do you mean by consequent, what do you mean by subsequent, what do you mean by obsequent, resequent, antecedent and superimposed kind of a drainage system. See here, the questions commonly asked is, are the Himalayan rivers or the peninsular rivers antecedent drainage system? What is an example of a superimposed drainage system in India? What do you mean by consequent drainage system? So these are the commonly asked questions in the preliminary examination, while the mains examination question can be classify the drainage system into different types. What do you mean by drainage system? What do you understand by drainage pattern? That is our next topic. And differentiate between the drainage system and the drainage patterns. So the first is the consequent drainage system. What is the meaning of the English word consequence? Due to something, result of something, that is the consequence. So remember, the consequent drainage system is the system which developed due to the slope of a land. So because the land is sloping in some particular direction, the river is also flowing in the same direction. So the consequent drainage system follows the regional slope of a land, and therefore it is an example of an sequent system, not an example of an insequent system. It follows the regional slope of the land. It is result of the consequence of the, it is result of, because of the sloping of the land in a particular way, the drainage system also follows the particular way. Therefore the name is the consequent drainage system. Now, in the consequent drainage system, just to classify it from the master river, from the other river, we call the consequent master stream. For example, Ganga to classify from Yamuna, Yamuna to classify from Chambal. Ganga is the main river whose main tributary is Yamuna. Yamuna has numerous tributaries whose one of the tributary is river Chambal. So to classify, and this entire system we call it as a Ganga river system. Now to classify the rivers from different types, we will say that Ganga is a consequent master stream. In the plain region I am talking. So Ganga is a consequent stream. So this is the first stream, this is the major stream which has been developed in an region. So remember here, what is a consequent drainage system? These are the first rivers or the first streams to develop in an region, to develop in an region. Now because these were the first streams to develop in an region, obviously they follow the regional slope of a land. So what you can write, the next point is, they follow the regional slope of a land. That is, they are following whether the land is sloping in this way. If this is the slope of a land, the stream which developed also was flowing in the same direction according to the slope of a land. So they follow the initial slope of a land, and the largest of all the streams, because they follow the initial slope, they are also known as the deep streams. They are also known as the streams which deep from one side to other. That is, they are following the deep, the land is dipping on this side, therefore the river is also flowing this side, therefore they are also known as the deep streams. Now the longest of all is known as master consequent, is known as master consequent. So again, take this, remember the consequent drainage system. These are the first streams to develop in a land, and because they are first streams to develop in a land, they are the known as the master consequence, because these are, and because they follow the initial slope of a land, that is where this land is sloping, they are also known as deep streams. They are also known as deep streams. Now coming to the second type of a drainage system, it is known as subsequent drainage system. Now what is the word subsequent means? That it follows something, it is subsequent to something, that it is following something. So the streams which follow or which develop on the land after the consequent stream, after the master stream which develop, are known as the subsequent streams. Also they follow the regional slope, therefore they are part of sequent drainage system. Don't forget that we are doing the sequent drainage system. So the subsequent streams, these originated after the master consequent, this originator after the master consequent streams, and they follow obviously the slope of a land. Now look here, if we are considering the Ganga drainage system, this is the master consequent. Later on, Yamuna drainage system, this becomes a subsequent stream. Now if we are, or the other tributaries of river Ganga, Ram Ganga, Kosi river system, this all are the Ghagra river system, this all are the examples of an subsequent stream. Now when we are considering only Yamuna system, we are not considering river Ganga, we are studying Yamuna as a separate river, then river Yamuna is a master stream, while another important tributary of river Yamuna, or these are the subsequent streams. For example, Chambal then becomes a subsequent stream, Sindh then becomes a subsequent stream, Betwa becomes a subsequent stream, Ken becomes a subsequent stream. That is the major tributaries. So what are these subsequent? They are the main tributaries of a river which originate after the development of a main river. So they are known as the subsequent stream. Now the third kind of a drainage system is the obsequent drainage system. Obsequent drainage system. The word obsequent means they are flowing in the opposite direction to the master consequent stream. The tributaries which flow in opposite direction to the master stream or to the main river, the rivers which flow in opposite direction to the flow of a main river before joining the main river are known as obsequent. So what you have to remember, O stands for opposite, O obsequent stands for opposite. So the tributaries which flow in opposite direction before joining the master consequent are known as obsequent streams or obsequent drainage system. Flowing in opposite direction before joining the master consequent are known as obsequent drainage system, are known as an obsequent drainage system. Now where will this happen? For example, if there is a main tributary, main river is flowing from north to south, and the tributary rivers flow from south to north before joining the main river system. It is there, this is the direction of a flow. Then this tributary river, which I have shown in red color, becomes the obsequent drainage system. Now, can it happen? Where does it happen in India? The three ranges of Himalayas, that is the greater Himalayas, middle Himalayas and the Shivalik ranges. Now there are numerous rivers, for example river Ganga, which originate in the east-west flowing mountains, which originate from this side of a mountain, of the inner Himalayas. Which originate on the southward facing slopes of the Himalaya, but there are numerous tributaries of river Ganga which originate on the northward facing slope of middle Himalayas, and as a result of this they flow in opposite direction before joining the river Ganga to the flow of river Ganga. They may be originating in the Shivaliks and the flow in opposite direction. So where is this obsequent drainage system found? In the east-west stretching mountains. If the master consequent originates on the other slope as compared to the tributaries, it is known as obsequent drainage system. For example, numerous Himalayan tributaries of major rivers such as river Ganga, which originate on the northward facing slopes of Himalayas, are an example of an master conceive are example of tributaries. North India, South India in the terms of Himalayas, Ganga originating here and flowing, while the other tributary originating on the other side and with them joining the river Ganga. So the example here you can write is example is streams originating from northward facing northern slopes of Himalayas before joining the main river such as Ganga, which originate from southern slope of Himalayas. So this is an obsequent drainage system. The streams originating from the northern slopes of Himalayas before joining the main river such as Ganga, which originate from the southern slope of the Himalayas. Now, lastly is the resequent drainage pattern. Now the word resequent means the streams which have recently originated. For example, if Ganga river originated 1,000 years back, then the tributary which originated some 500 years back becomes an example of an recent stream in compared to geological time scale. So it is an example of an resequent drainage. So the tributaries of a main rivers which originated in recent geological time are examples of an resequent streams. So these are the tributaries. Obviously, how is their flow? There is flow is again in the direction of a river. They do not flow in the opposite direction, otherwise we will classify them as an obsequent stream. But these are the tributaries which are of recent origin. So you have to remember the resequent. Very simple enough, resequent, recent. So the tributaries, why they are tributaries? Obviously because they are joining the main river. And because the main river is the older river, that is why we are saying it is a main river. So the tributaries, these are the tributaries. Which are of recent origin. And they obviously they follow the slope of a land. And therefore, again we are classifying them in the sequent kind of a drainage system. So these are the tributaries which are of the recent origin, and therefore we are classifying them as an example of a resequent type of a drainage system. So are you very comfortable with the sequent kind of a drainage system? Consequent, due to the consequence of a land, generally the first streams and therefore the main streams. Subsequent, which follow the main streams. Obsequent, which flow in the opposite direction to the mainstream. But why comes in the sequent? Because they are also following the slope of a land. They are not going opposite to the slope of a land. So river Ganga, which originates on the southern slope, it follows the slope of a land. Another river which originates on the northern slope, it is following its original slope of a land. Therefore obsequent is also an example of a sequent stream. Then resequent, drainage system, the tributaries which are of a recent origin, they are known as resequent streams. Now coming to the other kind of a drainage system, that is an example of an insequent drainage system. This is an insequent drainage system. It is an example of insequent drainage system. What is this insequent drainage system? As I already told you, they do not follow the regional slope of a land, because and therefore they do not follow the regional slope of the land, because they are like, we will not adjust to this geological structure. We have our own direction, will flow in the same direction. So they do not get adjusted to the regional slope. For example, if a river is flowing in a particular direction, and if according after the river, after the origin of a river, if there is an origin of a mountain system, and even if the mountain is formed, then river says, no, I won't change the direction, I will maintain my original course. So to maintain the original course, it will cut down the mountain and still it will maintain the original course. So the kind of a river, so it is not getting adjusted to the geological structure. That is, after the formation of a mountain, is it changing the path? No, it is like a stubborn child, it is maintaining its own path. So, or like a stubborn person, it is maintaining the own path. So, the insequent drainage system is a kind of a drainage system in which the rivers do not get adjusted to the geological structure and they follow their own path. So, they are not adjusted to the geological structure and they do not follow the initial slope of a land. So, we can take this. Not well adjusted to the geological structure. They do not follow the initial slope of a land and they are not well adjusted to the geological structure. So these are the insequent drainage system. Classify the insequent drainage system into two types. Antecedent drainage system antecedent drainage system. And superimposed drainage system. And superimposed drainage system. Now look at the word, two words here, antecedent drainage system. What does the word antecedent means? Older. So it is a drainage system which is older to the initial slope of a land, and because it is older to the initial slope of the land, it is not following the slope of a land. It is saying I won't adjust because I am an older river. So the rivers which were present before the uplifting of a mountain or before the upliftment of a land into a formation of a mountain. Upliftment means obviously land, mountain will be formed. So the kind of a drainage system which is of old origin, which is of older, and it was present before the folding of a land into the mountain, is known as antecedent drainage system. Example is an Himalayan river system. On other hand, the kind of a drainage system which was, what does the word superimposed means? Somebody is imposing that on you. You are not doing it on your own. No intrinsic motivation, but some kind of an external force is applying. Therefore, it is getting superimposed. So, therefore, same here, superimposed type of a drainage system. When the drainage system which was developed on an initial land system got superimposed on other kind of a geological structure, it is known as an superimposed drainage system. Now, why they are not well adjusted to the geological structure? Antecedent. Before the upliftment of a land, it was flowing in a particular direction. After the upliftment of a land, it is maintaining its own path. It does not get adjusted to the geological structure due to the upliftment of a land. Superimposed drainage system. It was flowing through an old geological formation. It got eroded. It got superimposed on a lower geological formation. It did not develop on a lower geological formation. It did not develop on the lower formation. So that is why superimposed. Fine? Confused? We'll look at this in detail now. Antecedent drainage system. It is an antecedent drainage system. That is, this is a kind of a drainage system which originated prior to the upliftment of a land. Upliftment of land, and because it originated before the upliftment of the land, even after upliftment, the rivers are maintaining their original course. And then even after upliftment, the rivers are maintaining their original course. How they will maintain even after upliftment, if they can actively cut down the valley in the mountains. That is, if this is a mountain which got uplifted, if the river can cut down into that mountain into a valley and still flow, then it is known as, then only they can maintain their original course. That is, if they can pass through the mountains. So this process in geography is known as down cutting. So they originated before the upliftment of a land, and even after upliftment, the rivers are maintaining their original course through active down cutting. Through active down cutting are known as antecedent drainage system. What it will downcut? Obviously its valley. Active downcutting are known as an antecedent drainage system. So that means these are the older rivers. Which were present before upliftment of a land. Which were present before the upliftment of a land. These are the older rivers which were present before the upliftment of a land. Now look at this example here. Now if this is a river which is flowing in such kind of a direction, before the upliftment of a land it was flowing this way. This land is very flat, this river is flowing in this such direction. Now after the upliftment of a land, the river has a two choices, that when the land gets uplifted, what are the two choices available to the river? The two choices are whether the river can maintain its original path, that it continues to flow, or it follows the slope of a land, that is it flows out, because it was flowing this way, it follows the slope of a land and goes on the either part of the slopes. Now if the river does follow the slope of a land and goes to the either part of a slope, then it is not an example of an antecedent drainage system, it is an example of a sequent drainage system. So obviously not this, we are not concerned with this. We are concerned, what do you mean by antecedent drainage system? That even after upliftment, the river has to maintain its original course. River continues to flow in that original course. Now when it will occur? It will occur when the river can actively cut down through the mountain while the process of upliftment is going on. So it maintains its valley by cutting inside the mountain when the process of an upliftment is going on. Then only we will call such river as an antecedent river. So here you will see that it is cutting down the mountains even though there is an upliftment going on, and so it maintains its original course. So when can it cut down into the mountain? It can actively cut down into the mountain if it forms valleys. So in the mountainous region you will see this is a common type of a topography, that there is a mountain and then there are valleys here. And these valleys are formed due to the active down cutting of a land surface, and the river keeps on maintaining its original course. That is, the river again cuts down through the mountains and maintain its original course, that it forms a valley and still maintain its original course. Now obviously this is the figure 1 prior to the upliftment, second, that is how the down cutting occurs, and the third figure is this figure, that is how the topography after the active down cutting will look like. So such kind of a drainage system is known as an antecedent drainage system. Are you getting this? One, initial course of a river, then after the upliftment started, the river did not change its original course, it kept on following the original course because it was engaged in active down cutting, and then overall development of a topography was like this. That is, there is a mountainous region, then there is a valley in between. So how can the river manage if the upliftment is very fast? then obviously the river will not be able to maintain its original course. Antecedent river system will be developed only in those rivers in which the river can manage to downcut the valley as in accordance with the rate of upliftment. So you can say here, you can write, it is this antecedent drainage system will develop if rate of upliftment matches with rate of downcutting. If the rate of upliftment matches with the rate of downcutting, what will be the examples here? Examples will be rivers in the folded mountain regions will be an examples of antecedent rivers. Fold mountains. In India, what are the fold mountains? Which is an example of a fold mountain in India? Himalayas. So the Himalayan river system is an example of an antecedent river system. So examples in the preliminary question, you can look, if the option is Himalayan rivers, then this Himalayan rivers are the examples of an antecedent river system. So they can give you which of the following rivers are example of antecedent. One, Indus, Ganga, Godavari, Kaveri. ABC, all of the above, none of the above. So answer is A is Indus, B is river Ganga, Himalayan river. C, Godavari, peninsular river. No, not the region of fold mountains. Cancel it. Kaveri in the peninsula, not a region of fold mountains. So the answer becomes Indus and Ganga river system. So the examples you can type, the Himalayan river systems. Himalayan rivers such as Indus, Satluj, Ganga, Brahmaputra, Gandak, River Kali, etc. are examples of antecedent drainage system. So you can take some of the examples, and if the examples is out of this, then you should obviously, you will know the river systems in India while doing the Himalayan river system. So you will see this. So these are the different kinds of, so this is that antecedent drainage system, the older drainage system which develops due before the upliftment of a land surface. Now the next drainage system is an superimposed drainage system. What is this superimposed drainage system? As I told you, it developed on different geological formation, or it originated on different, or we can say it developed on older geological formation. But over the period of time, over the period of time, it is flowing on other geological formation. It is flowing on some other geological formation, that is, it is being superimposed. It is being superimposed on some other geological formation. So it developed on an upper geological formation which was different. But over the period of time, it was superimposed. It is flowing on some other geological formation. So we can say it was superimposed on lower geological formation. Which was different from, which is different from upper geological formation. Which is different from upper geological structure. It originated on an upper geological structure which is very different from a lower geological structure on which it is flowing. Therefore, we can say it is superimposed on a lower geological structure. Such kind of a drainage system is known as a superimposed drainage system. Now, how is it? You are understanding it? Bit confusing? Now, have a look at the diagrams here. Now take a look of at this part, Deccan Peninsular part of India, that is the Deccan Lava Plateau region. We have already, you just have an idea that this is a part which has developed due to lava formation. Why? The earlier there was an metamorphic rock in this. And what are the rivers here? We have done now here. The rivers here are Godavari, Krishna, etc. These are the rivers which are flowing. So now, the rivers such as Krishna, Godavari, etc., they were developed on, if you look at the cross section, we can say it like this. Downwards there is a metamorphic rock. Upwards there is an formation of a lava, that is basalt rock structure, what we call as a black cotton soil. Or black soil. Now why is the black soil formed? Black soil is formed due to the formation of a lava. So this river Godavari, which was initially flowing, it developed on the upper geological formation which consisted of an lava flow, or which consisted of volcanic rocks. So if you remember basalt, while doing the basalt rock, we said that basalt is one of the rock which is more susceptible to the water erosion, and therefore it results into the formation of a soil known as an black cotton soil. So over the period of time, when the river is flowing through this upper geological formation, because of the weathering process, chemical weathering of due to river, mechanical weathering due to river, erosion by the river, this top layer of the soil gets eroded away, and then later on it looks in the peninsular India as if the river is now flowing through, and it looks as if now the river is flowing through a lower geological formation, which is mostly made up of metamorphic rock, while the upper rock has been eroded away. So now this river Godavari is flowing, or many of the peninsular rivers are now flowing through an lower geological formation, that is the metamorphic rock. Initially they developed on which kind of a geological formation? They developed on the lava surface, but now they are flowing on the metamorphic rock surface. See, obviously this central part is eroded maximum, this part will be eroded maximum. Why? Because the river will be flowing. So the river which was originally flowing on the lava surface, on the igneous rock, because of erosion, now it is flowing on the metamorphic rock. So that means it is superimposed on the lower metamorphic rock. Why? Because the lava has been eroded away. Such is an example of a superimposed drainage system. Where we can see this in India? In the Deccan lava plateau region. Initially there was Indian plate metamorphic rock. It was traveling continental drift. Remember, it was traveling volcanic eruption on the western side, so that metamorphic rock got covered by the igneous rock. Then the river systems developed. One of the example of a river system is River Godavari. River Godavari over the period of time has resulted into erosion of the upper rock, basaltic rock, and now it is flowing over the lower geological formation. So that is why we can say it has been superimposed on a lower geological formation. So in the first diagram, initially flowing through initially developed on volcanic rocks, now superimposed on lower rocks, metamorphic rocks, examples here are the river systems of peninsular India. Example is rivers of peninsular India. That is, example is, one is Godavari River, Krishna River, Son River, etc. That is, the rivers of peninsular India are an example of a superimposed drainage system, while the rivers of Himalayas are example of an antecedent drainage system. What is the difference between superimposed and antecedent drainage system? The first difference is, in antecedent drainage system there is an upliftment of a land. In the superimposed drainage system there is no upliftment. In the antecedent drainage system, the rivers maintain their original course by cutting of the valleys. In the superimposed drainage system, the rivers cut down the valleys and get superimposed on a lower geological formation. So the similarities, both are the part of insequent drainage system. The difference is, in the antecedent drainage system there has to be an upliftment of a land. So with this we are finished with the drainage system. So again, remember the table here and the examples. Okay, so thank you. We'll meet again with the drainage patterns.